All right, hello everyone. Part two of Slender the Arrival. We're gonna go ahead and finish up. We just got the gas inside, and we're going to see if we can finish this game. Alright, so earlier, on the last episode, I went from here over to the other side and got killed by a kid. Just running in the bushes. I also turned the brightness up from the last video because I realized it wasn't very good. But I still gotta figure out, there's a lock on this gate right here, and then the kid got me right over there. So I'm trying to figure out how to get the key for that lock so I can actually go through this time instead of backtracking into that. Wow. Just wow. Found it. Alright, well, that solved my entire situation. Hopefully we can see stuff better now. I mean, darkness in a horror game is pretty good, but not when you can't see anything in the video. So last time I ran straight through and had no problems until I backtracked. I'm kind of curious if I should just try that again. Just we go. What the fuck is that? Okay, hello. Oh my god, what is going on? Oh my god. He's just screaming behind me. I don't think I should turn around. I think I should just keep going. Dearest diary, Patricia still has yet to come home. Mother insists she ran off to search for wildflower again. But I know that's not true. It was that man, that thing grandmother keeps ranting on aloud. I do not think she's mad. I have seen the man myself. He watches us as we play. Patty went to him. I just know it. If only mother would listen. I wonder them when she'll come home. Rosie. That was some kind of hard text to read. Oh, another one. But it's more or less the same as it's always been. Maybe tomorrow. Maggie. June 2nd, 1905. Father is making us pray again tonight. It'll do no good. It's bothersome, if anything. And I'd bet anything Patty and Walt ran away from this miserable old place. And I don't blame them one bit. Grandmother and Rose insist on some fairy tale that a strange man took them away. Am I the only one keeping their wits around here? Maybe I should run away too. Maggie, June 9th, 1805. Oh. Watch the next VCR clip. Here we go. Oh, house had to go. It can't save me anymore. Supposed to head back down. That would make no sense. Need to pay a little bit more attention, I guess. Number 13. Meet me by the street in an hour. I left a list of things to bring with you. Leave everything else behind. I'll explain everything as soon as I see you. I know how to fix all of this. Don't tell Lauren about me. I'm so sorry for everything. This isn't your fault. I did this. By the time you read this, it's already too late for you. Don't let him into any more lives. This was all my fault. This can end with you. I let him in. Why did I ever let him in? I'm sorry for placing this burden on you. I wish it was all on me. This can't spread any further. Please, it all has to end with you. I wish there was some other way. It has to end. God forgive me. Thank you.
I'm so sorry.
Was it my fault Charlie disappeared? Is this my trial or my punishment? I need to end it. I need to cleanse this place. No more suffering. No one deserves this. It all ends here. It all needs to go. That must be the sun then. Pretty exciting, isn't it? This whole mystery, the missing boy, the sightings, the arson. I'm glad I got to share this adventure with you. I can't help but feel saddened for Mr. Matheson. He lost so much. I wish he would have just let me in to help him the way you're helping me. Maybe I could have saved him. Since I couldn't help him in life, maybe I can help him now. I promise to find out what happened to his son. Perhaps that will put his soul at peace. Thanks again. Yeah, I look forward to your adventure. See ya. Thank you everyone for joining. I'm gonna end the stream there since we gotta watch or finish the entire game.